Well, good morning, boys and girls. It's Uncle Aaron again, and thanks for joining me for today's Bible Zone video. Today, we're going to get started with our action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with the Bible Zone praise song. Are you ready to get started? Okay, here we go. Today's action memory verse is from the book of John, chapter 1, verse 14. And it says this. It says, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." So that's a really long action memory verse, isn't it? But it's a very important one. So where it says, "The Word became flesh." So that's talking about Jesus. Jesus is the spoken word of God, okay? And he became flesh. He came to this earth. Even though he's always been God, he's always lived forever, he came to this earth as a man. He became flesh. So we're going to see some actions in a little bit that's going to explain all of this. And it says, "We have seen his glory." In other words, we've seen how amazing and powerful he is. And it says that he is the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. All right? So now let's do it with some actions. Are you ready? Okay, so we're going to say John, and we're going to make like a J here with our fingers. John chapter 1, verse 14. And it says, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we have seen his glory, glory as the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." All right, give yourselves a hand. Last week's video was called "Jesus' Miracles Prove That He Is God." Let's see what happens in this week's video.
Great crowds of people followed Jesus wherever he went. One day, Jesus went up on a mountain. He sat down and began to teach about the kingdom of God.
First, Jesus taught about the blessings that come to those who follow him. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the humble, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs."
Then Jesus taught how believers should live. Jesus said that believers are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. "Let your light shine before others so that they may see the good things you do and praise God."
Then Jesus taught about God's law. Jesus did not come to get rid of the law, but to obey it perfectly. He said that to enter heaven, a person can't just look righteous on the outside like the religious leaders. A person must be righteous on the inside too, obeying God for the right reasons.
Jesus said, "Love your enemies and pray for them. If you do this, you will be true children of your Father in heaven. He makes the sun rise on both the good and the evil, and he causes rain to fall on both the righteous and unrighteous. If you only love those who love you, what reward will you get for that? Even people who don't know God do that. Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect."
Jesus taught people what it means to follow him. He taught how people should live. People who trust in Jesus live to honor God and show what his kingdom is like.
So, boys and girls, today's lesson is something that is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 5. Now, some people refer to this as the Sermon on the Mount. And they called it that because Jesus was on a large mountain talking to a huge crowd of people. and he was teaching them about God's love for us and telling them how we should live and love other people. Now, Jesus was the most amazing teacher ever. But boys and girls, he was so much more than just a teacher. He is the Son of God. And so we really need to understand that when we hear about this or when we read what he's saying in the Bible, this isn't just an amazing teacher, this is God talking. So we should really pay attention and listen to what he's saying. Jesus was telling people how they can love the people around them, and that when we do that well, it helps other people to see who God is. Because think about it, in the world that we live, when somebody makes you mad, most people tell you, oh, you should get back at them, and you should, if they said something mean to you, you should say something mean back. Or if they did something bad to you, you should do something bad back. And that's how people in the world, and in the worldly system, that's how we think sometimes. But Jesus was telling us that we shouldn't do those things. We should do what God does, and God is always good. He loves us even when we don't love him well. So he was teaching us that when we live the way that he tells us to live, instead of the way that the world or people tell us to live, when we do that, we represent God and we show people how real God is and how amazing his love is. And we can't do that on our own. We need the Holy Spirit. We need God to help guide us to do the right thing. Now, some of the things that Jesus taught, they sound completely crazy to us, because guess what? He said, love your enemies. That doesn't even make sense, because when I think about my enemies or people who I don't like or who don't like me, I have a hard time loving them and being kind to them. But that's what God commands us to do, to love our enemies and to pray for people who are hurtful towards us. Those are things that God doesn't suggest that we do. There are things that he commands us to do. So we really need to do those. And those show that God's way of doing things are completely different from our way of doing things or the world's way of doing things. But always remember that God's way of doing things is always what's best, not just for us, but for everybody around us. And so we need to share God's love and show his love in every situation. So, boys and girls, you might ask the question, if I do bad things sometimes, am I still a Christian? Well, that's a really important question, boys and girls, and I want to answer it like this. If you have truly trusted in Jesus as your Savior, and you've made that decision in your heart, and they're not just words that you're saying, you really mean it in your heart, if you've trusted in Him as your Savior, then you are saved. You are a Christian. Now, the truth is that we still will struggle with sin, make bad decisions, and do bad things sometimes. And that's just true because of the fact that we live in a broken world. But that doesn't mean that we are not a Christian anymore. And in fact, we don't become a Christian by doing good things or not doing bad things. Okay? We should do good things and we should not do bad things. But that's not how we become a Christian. So when we are a Christian because we've trusted in what Jesus has done, we should want to do good things because of how much we love God. And we should not want to do bad things because of how much we love God. But when we do make those mistakes, we should seek forgiveness from God. We should go to people that we've hurt and make things right. So when we are Christians, we're still going to make mistakes. But we cannot earn our way to heaven. We are saved, we're God's children, he loves us. He knows we're gonna make mistakes sometimes, but we should try to obey him. And when we fail, we should turn away from our sin and go back to God and obey him, follow what he wants us to do, and make things right with any people that we've hurt. Boys and girls, I'd like to close with this. We've been learning about how our love for other people can be an example of God's love for us. So in what way can you show love to other people? Well, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible Zone praise song. The song that we're doing today is called Our Creator and King. This song is reminding us that God is all-powerful. He's amazing. He's God. He's our creator, but he's also our king. So let's think about that and let's worship him and praise him and really think about the words that we're singing as we sing this song, our creator and king. Well, boys and girls, before we close in our prayer today, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all, I'd love to hear from you. So you can email me at the email address below, but make sure you get mom or dad's permission first. All right, let's pray to God. Dear God, I thank you for the way that you love us. And I thank you that you show us how you want us to live and to love other people. I pray that we would learn to obey you, not so that we can be saved, because we can't obey you enough in order to be saved, but so that we can show how much we love you and love other people. So help us to follow you and to do what you've asked us to. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, Jesus came to teach us about God and his kingdom. I'll see you next week.